Hello guys, like I know it's been like forever since I recorded like anything. I've been having a lot going on. This video is gonna be a little different. I might not be talking like as loud as I normally do, and that's just because I'm in the process of getting braces, you know. I just had two of my wisdom teeth pulled out, so got a whole lot of other things going on. Might see my son in the background because I'm recording in the bedroom today. I've started something called anonymous emailing. You've probably seen it before, but basically, I mean, I know that a lot of people suffer from depression sometimes. We all kind of go through that, you know what I'm saying? And I created this because some people feel as if they have no one to particularly talk to, and they keep it, you know, inside, and normally some things happen, you know, which could have been prevented if they had someone to talk to. So I named it anonymous emailing because they don't have to say who they are. They can keep it to themselves, and I'll be reading the email and I'll be giving my personal point of view, and they're looking for you guys to, you know, also comment in the comment section about how you guys feel. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and get into this. She named it, because I can say male or female, you know, I'm not giving out any names. She named it My Life. Okay, I'm reading off of my computer. Okay, so if I'm looking that way, that's just because I'm reading the email. Okay, it says, "Hi, how are you? I'm doing fine. I hope you're doing great as well. I would like to remain anonymous, please, and thank you. Currently, I'm 35 years old with two children. I got married when I was 18 years old. My first child was a beautiful little girl. She is 10, and my handsome son is 2. My husband is this, tongue twisted, this is the wrong time. My husband is the sole provider. I work part-time, and I feel like I will be stuck here forever. The relationship is verbally and physically abusive. Since I've gained weight, he told me nobody will want me. And growing up in a household where my mother would degrade me by calling me horrible names and physically and mentally abusing me has caused me to run into men like him, I believe. I am depressed. I don't love myself anymore, and the woman I've become, I have caught myself mistreating my children sometimes out of anger. I've even tried to commit suicide numerous times before. I don't know what to do. I feel like a horrible mother. Because of depression, it has caused me not to be a part of their lives completely, and more so push them away. I feel bad telling you this, but I would really, I would really like to know if there's anyone else, if there is anyone else out there feeling how I feel or felt the way I felt. Any advice will help me in the long run. I feel as if my life is over at my age because I'm 35 years old. I feel like it's too late to start over. My husband has cheated on me and gave me an STD numerous times. I am afraid next time it'll be something that I can't get rid of. What do I do?" Okay, first of all, congratulations to your bundle of joy, you know, your daughter and your son. I mean, having a child, it can become overwhelming, trust me, because I have a son of my own. He's 2. He'll be turning 3 in December. So I completely understand, you know, with being overwhelmed. As far as the weight change, I completely understand where you're coming from with that as well. I used to be a really nice size, 136 exactly, never been anything bigger than that. When I got pregnant, I reached up to like 210. I'm 5'11". That's way too big for my height. I am still currently losing weight. If you look at my past videos, by just looking at this video, you could tell that I've lost weight. But it is a very hard process, but that does not mean that you have to stop loving yourself. I know sometimes it can be hard, but you have to continue to push and strive for your children. Your children should be your number one motivation. Just because you're 35, number one, doesn't mean that it's too late to start over. Any moment you feel like you're ready for a new start, you can do it. Never let anyone tell you, and never let a man define who you are. I just feel as if you need time to find yourself, find something that's like an outlet, whether it's writing, going to the park, just doing something that's more active for you. And this is advice that I've received personally, because I'm not going to sit here and say, hey, it's too easy, because sometimes it's not. Trust me, I know. I've been there before. And as far as you trying to do self-harm to yourself, don't do it, baby. And I say this because you're not just hurting yourself, you're hurting others, you're hurting your precious babies, you're hurting other people that love you. It's people that love you, and sometimes you may feel as if that no one loves you, and that's because the depression is beginning to take control over you mentally and sometimes physically, and you just feel as if you're the only one by yourself against the world. But that's not true. That's not. You have to be open. But be careful who you're open to. As far as your husband goes, I feel as if you're not happy and it's a verbal and a physical abusive relationship, I only can tell you so much as far as happiness doesn't cost much, honestly. I just feel as if a peace of mind doesn't cost much neither. And I feel like a peace of mind is way much worth than trying to stick out a relationship. I know most of the time we try to stick it out for the children, but sometimes it will not always work that way. You have to do what's good for you. You have to do what's going to be beneficial for you and your children as well, but you too. You know what I'm saying? And it's not too late to start over. And don't let him or anyone tell you just because you've gained weight that nobody will love you, because that's not true. That's not true. That's just something to say to you to make you stay. And don't question who you are. You are you. You've always been you, even before you met him. And you don't want it to be toxic, and you don't want your children to look at these things that's going on and think, hey, you know, this is okay. You know, mommy tolerates it, and daddy do that to mom. And so, man, you know, like, children are sponges. I mean, and normally what they see, they think it's okay. And you don't want them to think that's okay. And as far as when you stated you feel like a horrible mother because you push your kids away sometimes, you're not the only one. I don't care. If someone say that they don't be like, leave me alone sometimes, they're lying. Because every mother or father has had moments where they just feel like they're about to lose their mind. And they just need space to just get their mind in order. That's normal. You know, sometimes you could just get overwhelmed. I mean, that's just life. We're living life. And that's just what life can consist of sometimes. And I know that you could be angry about situations, but sometimes I can sense what you're saying when you said mistreat. I don't think you mean like physically or mentally abusing them, but just pushing them off, you know, have them gone away from you, and maybe telling them to go sit down. You don't feel like being bothered. That can affect them too. I mean, you have to find a way to work around it, because you want to be involved in their life too. You know, they're very young and they want to be a part of, they want you to be a part of their lives. They want to play with you. They want to do things with you. And sometimes you have to learn how to hide that pain that you're, you know, that you're feeling inside, and kind of work with them too, play with them, you know, be around them, because you don't know what they're thinking. Children are young, and little do you know, they committing suicide nowadays too. So you don't want to push your kids off You know what I'm saying? You want to be there for them as well. I just feel as if I see the part when you talk about the STDs and stuff like that. Baby girl, do not jeopardize your life. And I know that you might love him. And I'm not going to be like, oh yeah, it's so easy, girl. You can move on and da 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 da. I can give you so much advice in that department. But at the end of the day, as an individual, you know when you're reaching. You know when you've reached your breaking point. Period. When you're tired and you're fed up. That's it. You have to figure that out. You have to figure that out. Because I could tell you so much. And I could tell you so much right now. It might push you more to him. And normally, that's what happens. I don't know what's up with that when it comes to you, us as human beings. When someone tells us not to do something, we end up doing it anyway. I don't want you to jeopardize your life. Because you have two other people to look after. And from that man above looking over you to not have it be something that you can't get rid of. It's there for life, baby. You can move on. You can move on. You can really move on. It's never, ever, ever, ever too late. It's never too late. It don't matter how old you are. It is never too late to try to start over. I'm telling you. Look at this guy back there. But it's never too late. And I'm being serious. And I'm kind of new to this when it comes to, you know, talking over the camera and giving advice. And I'm still looking at the email as I'm responding. Bye-bye. You leaving me? Okay. Bye-bye. You saying bye-bye, but you coming over here. Okay, back to the video. You stated that growing up that your mom used to degrade you by calling you names and being physically and mentally abusive to you. I just feel as if that can play a major part sometimes. It just all really depends on the situation, but you cannot let that situation define your life. You know your worth. It's just, you shouldn't settle. You, as human beings, we get too content with where we are sometimes. That sometimes we think we don't deserve more or better. And I think that's kind of maybe the state of mind that you're in. Maybe you're content, but don't. If you feel as if you deserve better and you know what you've been through as a child growing up, you should want better. And I'm not trying to dictate your life. I'm just giving advice to you. And you want better for your children. You want them to be in a better surrounding. You don't want them to be in the same surrounding that you grew up in. And sometimes we keep the cycle going in families. That sometimes all it takes is that one person to break that cycle. And you can be that one. Break that cycle. Break them chains. You can do it. And don't let him get in your head and be like, oh, no, you can't leave. And you can leave. You can do as you please. There is people out there to help. And if you need help, don't be afraid to ask. I really, really, really would hate to see, like, something happen to you or them children. Like, you're an amazing woman and you're a beautiful woman. And never, ever, ever forget that. And don't let nobody tell you otherwise, period. Don't keep things bottled up inside because you feel like people will judge you. First of all, people gonna judge and people gonna talk. But most of the people that's like that, they have no room. Everybody goes through things. Everybody. Everybody has their own personal battles. But battles like this, when you're trying to commit suicide and you're fighting depression and you don't want to talk about it, you keep all the anger and everything balled up inside you. You can't do that because then the end results, can be deadly. And not only hurting you, like I said before, but hurting others around you. I hope that I've said enough. I hope that I helped in some way. I really do. I'm going to be posting this on the channel, and I'm going to be posting it on Facebook, because I know that you want others to give advice, because you ask, what do I do? And you want to hear if someone else have been in your shoes before. And maybe someone have, and maybe somebody has already went past that, and they're not afraid to actually speak on it. Or you have people that have more better advice than me, that you'll be able to see on Facebook, and you'll be able to see on the YouTube channel. And you take that advice from all these different people that I'm hoping that will help and give you advice. And you take that advice and you run with it. Whatever decision you make, own it. Own it. And that's it, guys. I know this is a whole different video. I normally do other things, but I just really wanted to get this email out because it kind of touched me a little bit. And it seemed, it was very urgent, you know. She put urgent in parentheses. So I'm assuming that she wants this to be read immediately. I have other emails as well that I'll be posting too. Just give me time. But thank you guys for watching. And I know you've been like, where you been, woman? But I'm back. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And please, please, please don't be afraid to give this young lady advice. Please and thank you. Have a blessed day or night. We out of here.